Hi guys, Archie here. So for this video, it's about the Li Ao showcase about comparison with the Tolan. So if you haven't watched the previous video, which is the how to counter Ikki, you can watch that one first. So that one there, I did mention about the Tolan team, the manual part, right? So Tolan have to be manual in fighting the the Ikki counter. But Li Ao is actually a better Tolan if we are talking in the situation of countering Ikki. Because Tolan, you have to manual to actually shoot on Mavis to ban out Mavis from the battle. But Li Ao AI is a bit special. And they have the same skill, which is the Devour. So Tolan 1 is 0 hour, Li Ao 1 is Devour. So they have the same skill effect. And then Li Ao also have a speed leader of 20%. So let's take a look how is his performance in Point War. Okay, so here's an example of a speed team fighting a tank team, right? So this is not a proper speed team. I just want to put AoE damage here to actually just to fight Jumoni here. So this is just an example video. So let's see, Tolan here is my speed leader, right? So Tolan here, S3 will actually land on Jin Yu Yao. Because in Point War, this is in Point War, so if because Point War you can tune your own speed, and most of the time for all those like tank team here, you will tune your speed, your higher speed to be Jin Yu Yao, because Jin Yu Yao cannot get stunned, which means Tolan S3 will land on Jin Yu Yao and nothing happened to Jin Yu Yao. So let's take a look. So let's take a look what happens on the enemy team here. Okay, so let's see if I blitz it now. I actually lost. Why did I lose? So if you take a look at the replay here, my Tolan S3 will land on Jin Yu Yao. This is the default AI when you make it on auto, because Tolan S3 will always try to hit the enemy's highest AP at the moment, which is at enemy's Jin Yu Yao. So the 0 hour here is considered as incapacitate, and then enemy Jin Yu Yao passive is immune to incapacitate. So and the highest AP within the enemy team here is their Jin Yu Yao, because they build the Jin Yu Yao the fastest. So Jin Yu Yao will get the S3 damage from Tolan, and Tolan won't be able to 0 hour anyone. That's why we lost here. So if we actually change it to Li Ao, Li Ao is the baby Tolan, right? So if you compare like speed wise, base speed wise, everything here Li Ao will actually lost. But Li Ao have a very special AI. Li Ao will actually target Mavis. Okay, so Li Ao have the same thing, which is the Devour here. It's the same effect as Tolan's S3, the 0 hour. But he have a lower speed, so he's 20%, Tolan have 25%. Of course, if you use Li Ao in fighting in speed battle, of course you will lose because like TA have 25%, Ollie have 25%, and their speed is faster than Li Ao. So most of the time you'll get outspeed if you're using Li Ao leader. But in speed team vs tank team, no way I'm actually getting outspeed by the tank team here. So it is a very good match here to actually use Li Ao to fight tank team, because Li Ao AI is different. So let's take a look at Li Ao's AI. So now I blitz, I actually win. But what is the difference? I just changed Tolan out to Li Ao. So Li Ao here, his AI will actually target Mavis. So let's take a look here. So my Feng Shun buff my team by myself. And then now the enemy highest AP here is Jin Yu Yao, right? So if you are using in Tolan situation, you actually S3 on Jin Yu Yao. But let's take a look, Li Ao S3 will actually hit on Mavis. His AI will target Mavis first, which is very good, because now Mavis is banned out from the battle, which means now the enemy team is only have Jin Yu Yao, Everett, Sally, and Ikki. So Ikki lost his most powerful protection with Mavis. Then now, if I use my ribbon, I can just instantly able to kill Ikki fast. Now I just need to cast another AoE damage from my Archibald. Okay. Then, blah blah blah. Then Ikki died. So after Ikki died, this team have no such thing as a threat to me, because the only DPS in their team here is actually Ikki. So if you want to play a speed cleef to fight Ikki's team, you can actually consider using Li Ao as your speed leader, only able to fight enemy's tank team. Okay, so like this kind of team you are not able to fight because it's a speed team. This kind of speed team plus Ikki team you are not able to fight because you'll get outspeed by enemy Tolan, all those stuff. And maybe this thing you're able to fight, but it also depends on can you kill Ikki and can you kill like Donner stuff, because Donner here can actually AoE damage you, can most probably kill my team as well. So it is depends on how you beat your team as well. Doesn't mean that you put Lee out, you win. There's no such thing as this, like you put this thing Esper, then you straight away win. It's all about your team combination. So this video here is just sharing that Lee Ao is actually a very strong rare Esper to actually counter Ikki's meta. So let's say this one here. Enemy have like R6 Lien, R6 Sujie, R4 Jinchu, right? So even my Lee Ao banned Mavis out, I have a high chance to not actually able to kill Ikki. First thing, Ikki is R1, he can have the sleep no more at the start of combat. And then there's a R6 Lien here to actually protect Ikki as well, and Sujie to protect Ikki. So like the within the same team, maybe I won't actually able to win him, because it's different than the previous team. The previous team, it relies on Mavis to protect only. But this team here, it relies on Mavis and Lien and Sujie. So it's more protection to protect Ikki. So I'm not, the showcase now I'm showing is not about how bad Ikki is. It's about how high investment you actually have to protect Ikki. And actually we have a lot of counter to fight Ikki as well. Like if you see my previous video, I actually posted a lot of strong Ikki showcase, right? Then you guys is like, so disappointed, it's like no counter. But now I'm gonna post the counter video, and please don't say Ikki is useless. Okay, Ikki is not useless, just that it depends on how good you are able to protect him. If you can't make a team that protect him well, like if you just rely on Mavis protection on Ikki, you probably lose to a Lee Ao team. But if you put like R6 Lien, or maybe you have like R2 Lien, if you're like Sally, if you're like Sujie, to actually protect Ikki with a good environment, then most probably the out team can't even win you as well. In the end of the day, it still depends on what is the enemy team and what is your team actually trying to fight the enemy. You have to actually think and actually try to build the team around the team idea. So it's important you actually know that what kind of team you are trying to build, or what type of team you're actually trying to fight. Like my previous video, I posted a lot of team. It doesn't mean that you have to copy paste the team. You can actually switch around your team Esper, as long as you know what is the core team idea to actually fighting with the enemy team. Alright, so that's all for the video here. It's just a main showcase to actually show you that Lee Ao is actually a better choice than Tolan if you're trying to fight a Ikki tank team that only relies on Mavis. So you can see I can just blitz them, because that team there only relies on Mavis. A team previously only relies on Mavis protection, and the rest is like trying to DPS. So it's a bad idea if you're trying to do that, because AI will instantly bite your Mavis. But of course, Tolan player can also do that, because Tolan player can just manual by themselves and ban out your Mavis. Alright, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. Feel free to comment down how do you think about Lee Ao and the Ikki situation. So Ikki is broken if you can protect him. Ikki is useless if you can't protect him. So this is it's a very high gap. It's either very broken or either useless because you can't protect him. Oh, before we end the video, so at the back of the video, I'll put Agni's showcase about his Lee Ao team. He's actually PvEing people in PvP. So he's using Lee Ao team to actually blitzing people now, because Lee Ao AI is actually able to eat Mavis. Alright, so yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and see you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Special thanks for all the direct support on the YouTube membership. So for the benefactor of R tier, which is Gen MP, thanks for the support. And for the supporter or patron of R tier, which is Louis Schneider, Agni, Gemmai, Code Wardeners, Molkult Regulan, Ziggy, Wang Tamer, Karma Rookie, and Sun Waltz, thank you so much for the support. And special thanks to Louis Schneider and Agni for the 2 months track of the support. So hope you guys enjoy the video and see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.